Good morning, my dear students. So quadratic equation part 9. So in this last part also I discussed some previous year model problems. So in this session I'm continuing those model problems. So I'm discussing those problems which are appear minimum 2 times in the previous JEE examinations, both mains and advanced. Okay, so the first problem is we have to find the least integral value. It is given that n minus 2 into x square plus 8x plus n plus 4 is greater than 0 for all x belongs to R. Given that this quadratic expression is always greater than 0 for all x belongs to R, then what is the least integral value of n? That means we have to find the least integer n satisfying this inequality. See, this is look like ax square plus bx plus c greater than 0 for all x belongs to R. So which is true only when x square coefficient n minus 2 must be positive and discriminant should be negative. What is the discriminant? B square, 8 square, 64 minus 4ac, 4 into a value how much? N minus 2 into c how much? n plus 4 is less than 0. So n minus 2 greater than 0 means n is greater than 2 only, no? So here divide with the minus 4, what you will get? N minus 2 into n minus 4, n plus 4 minus 16 greater than 0 divided by what? Minus 4. Now simplify this, you will get n square plus 2n minus 24 greater than 0. So wavy curve method. Okay, so first you find the factors here. Anywhere highest n square coefficient is positive, highest n power is n square positive. So find the factors, you will get n plus 6 into n minus 4 greater than 0. Wavy curve method. So fifth session we discussed now. So anywhere here it is a product of non-repeated linear factors. Okay, and here in each factor n coefficient is positive. So draw the real line. What are the roots? Minus 6 plus 4. Identify on the real line. Always after greater root, what do we have to keep? Plus. So 4 is a root because of n minus 4, whole power 1, odd number is there. So we have to change the sign. Minus 6 is a root because of n plus 6, whole power 1 is there, odd number. So we have to change the sign. That means n plus 6 to n minus 4 is greater than 0 is possible only when n is less than minus 6 or n is greater than 4 and n is greater than 2. Okay, so for all these what is the common part? For that also just again draw the real line. N is greater than 2, so 2 is not included. Keep the circle at 2. N is greater than 2. Next, n is less than minus 6. N is less than minus 6 or n is greater than 4. Or n is greater than 4. So for all these, what is the common part? The common part is what? N is greater than 4. So that means for all these, what is the common part you will get? The common part will be n is greater than 4. N is greater than 4. Then what is the least integer greater than 4? It is 5. So the least integer n satisfying n greater than 4 is n is equal to 5. So how we got n value greater than 4? Because of this. So that means the least integral satisfying this quadratic inequality is what? 5. So this is the first question in this session. Next, the same thing, same model problem. Second one also just like that, this model only. Second problem, if the inequality m into x square plus 3x plus 4 divided by x square plus 2x plus 2 is less than 5. So it is given that this inequality is true for all x belongs to R. For all x belongs to R. then we have to find m value, the set of values of m satisfying this inequality. Okay, the set of values of m satisfying this inequality for all x belongs to R. And here if you observe, what is the denominator? X square plus 2x plus 2. That x square plus 2x plus 2, can I write like this? X plus 1 whole square plus 1, no problem, no? So x plus 1 whole square plus 1 is always positive number only, no? So that means we can cross multiply this factor. Okay, we can cross multiply this factor. Anyway, it is a positive quantity, inequality remains same. Okay, so if you cross multiply, what you'll get? Mx square plus 3x plus 4 is less than 5x square, 5 into 2x, 10x, plus 5 into 2, 10. All the terms you transfer and group up the like terms, then you will get mx square plus 5x square, if you transfer this side, minus 5x square. So x square common, m minus 5, 3x minus 10x minus 7x, 4 minus 10 minus 6, less than 0, for all x belongs to R. So when it is possible, when ax square plus bx plus c is less than 0 for all x belongs to R, when it is possible, it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c less than 0 for all x belongs to R. Under what condition it is possible? When x square coefficient should be negative and discriminant is also negative. So what is the discriminant? B square is what? 49 minus 4ac, minus 4 into minus 6 plus 24 into a, how much? M minus 5 is less than 0. So from this, what you'll get? M is less than 5, and from this, what you'll get? M value is, I'm writing directly, less than 71 by 24. So 71 by 24, 24 threes are 72. That means it is nearer to 3 only. So less than 3 only. So we have to find common solution for these two inequalities. So to get that common solution, draw the real line. According to first, M is less than 5. So 5 not included, keep the circle. Okay. Next, M is less than 71 by 24. So 71 by 24 is a number. It is smaller than 3. So automatically it is smaller than 5 also. So for these two inequalities, what is the common part? M is less than 71 by 24. So thus M is less than 71 by 4 means what? M belongs to open interval minus infinity comma 71 by 24. So for these values of M, this inequality holds for all x belongs to R. Next. So I think you have learned this in lower classes. X minus a into x minus b into x minus c, product of these three factors. So how you have learned? X cube minus of a plus b plus c into x square plus ab plus bc plus ca into x minus abc. I think I have learned this product. Okay, so this is, I'm writing like this, x cube minus s1 into x square plus s2 into x minus s3. Okay, what is s1 now? A plus b plus c. That means s1 is, suppose if you equate this product A equal to 0, what you'll get? X values a, b, c. That means a, b, c are roots. So that means s1 denotes what? Sum of the roots. S3 denotes what? Product of the roots. S2 denotes what? Sum of the product of the roots taken two at a time. And here if you observe, if the suffix, here what is the suffix? 1. Here what is the suffix? 3. 1 and 3, what kind of numbers? Odd numbers. For odd numbers, what you are getting? Sign, minus sign. And 2 is even number. So if the suffix is even number, what you are getting? Plus sign. And if you observe the terms, x cube next to x square, that means power 1 is decreased, next x, next constant term. So it is true even if you take four terms also. That means if you consider x minus a into x minus b into x minus c into x minus d. What is this product means? What you'll get? X power 4. Because 4 factors now all are non-repeated linear factors. Okay. So minus s1 into x cube. Next plus s2 into x square. Next minus s3 into x plus s4. So what is s1? Sum of the roots a plus b plus c plus d in this case. What is s2? Sum of the product of the roots taken two at a time. Like ab plus bc plus cd plus ad plus ac plus bd. Okay. So ab, ac, ad plus bc. AB plus AC plus AD plus BC plus BD plus CD, S2. Like that S3 means product of the, sum of the product of the roots taken three at a time. Like ABC plus ACD plus etc. Okay. S4 is product of the roots ABCD. Okay. Now the question is, previous year mains problem. Find what is the coefficient of x power 99 in the product of these 100 non-repeated linear factors, x minus 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3 into and so on, x minus 100. So clearly here, how many factors are there? 100 factors only, no? So here 1, in first factor 1 is there, second factor 2 is there, that means here 100 is there, means it is 100th factor and all are non-repeated linear factors. In this we have to find coefficient of x power 99. As it contains 100 non-repeated linear factors, if you multiply, what you will get? Highest x power 100 only, na? Next, alternatively, after plus, minus s1 into x power 99. Next, what you will get? Plus s2 into x power 98. Plus and so on, sorry, minus and so on. Finally, what you will get? S100. Suffix 100 is even now, so compulsory sign will be plus sign. Okay? So, but according to the question, we have to find what? X power 99 coefficient. What is the x power 99 coefficient? Minus S1. So, the answer is minus S1. That is minus sum of the roots. So, what are the roots of these factors? Suppose if you equate these factors to 0, what are the roots? 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. 100 only, right? So, the sum of the roots, what you get? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on. 100. So it is the sum of 100, first 100 natural numbers. What is the formula? N into, that is 100 into N plus 1, 100 plus 1 divided by 2. So minus is 2 ones are 250 is a 50 into 101 is a 5050. So answer is minus 5050. And remember, okay. If you remember, if all these are all plus, then here all you will get plus signs only. All are plus. Okay? If all are minus, then alternatively in the product you will get alternative plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. Okay? Suppose here in the factors all are in the form of x plus a, x plus b, x plus c, then what you will get? Here x cube plus s1 x square plus s2 x plus s3. Okay? So next problem. So based upon common roots concept, so given that the quadratic equations x square plus ax plus b is equal to 0, x square plus bx plus a is equal to 0, have a common root. Then we have to find absolute value of a plus b or numerical value of a plus b. Absolute value, numerical value, nothing but modulus of a plus b. That means if you are getting a plus b positive or negative, you have to take positive sign only. Numerical value means modulus. Okay. So already I did this model problem. So in that problem, only in one equation unknown is there. So that's why I solved the equation which do not contains unknowns. I'm finding the roots. And suppose if x is equal to alpha, x is equal to beta, I got the roots. If x is equal to alpha is a common root. Alpha is also a root of second equation. From that I will get unknown. So suppose if x is equal to beta is a common root, then by substituting x is equal to beta in second equation, I got some unknown value. I did that method. Or one more method is what? Condition. Directly you can use common roots condition. And one more third method is, I'm applying third method for this. Third method is, so make the x square coefficient is the same in both equations. Make the x square coefficient in both, make the x square coefficient is same in both equations, then subtract. Subtracting x square will be cancelled, you will get a linear. So on solving you will get x value. Whatever you are getting x value, that is the common root. That is the common root of these two equations. Okay, suppose if you got that common root is directly constant, then don't worry. So over the problem, if they ask common root, that is over. Suppose if you got x value in terms of unknown values, so you substitute that unknown value in the equation so that you will get that unknown value. Okay, so anyway, here they're asking what modulus of a plus b. They're asking what numerical value of a plus b. Okay, so anyway, here x square coefficient both are same. Okay, x square coefficient both equations are same. On subtracting, what you'll get? Ax minus bx is a minus b into x plus b minus a is equal to 0. Or a minus b into x is equal to a minus b. So this implies that x is equal to what you'll get? 1. So x is equal to 1 is the common root, but they are not asking common root. They are asking what? A plus b absolute value. Now as x is equal to 1 is a common root, then x is equal to 1 is a root of first equation as well as second equation. That means x is equal to 1 satisfies both equations. So you substitute x value 1 in either first equation or second equation. I am putting this x value in first equation. If you want, you can check by substituting x value 1 in second equation. You will get same only. So if I substitute x value 1 in first equation, what I will get? 1 plus a into 1, a plus b is equal to 0. So from this, what you will get? A plus b is equal to minus 1. But what they are asking? Absolute value. So, modulus of a plus b is equal to modulus of minus 1 is 1. Over. Okay. So, next you look at one more problem based upon common roots. So, the value, find the value of b for which x square plus bx minus 1 is equal to 0. And x square plus x plus b is equal to 0 have a common root. So same model problem. Okay, so here they're asking absolute value of a plus b. Here they're asking find the value of b. So if you want, you can subtract. So same method, you apply third method only. Okay, on subtracting, here x square get cancelled. Here what you'll get? B minus 1 into x, am I correct? And next you have minus 1 minus b is equal to 0. So thus x is equal to what you got? 1 plus b by b minus 1. So whatever we are getting x value, this x value is the common root. But still we are not getting b value. We need to find b value here. Okay, so here just we got common root. So here x is equal to 1 plus b by b minus 1 is a common root for these two equations. Then you can substitute this x is equal to 1 plus b by b minus 1 either in first equation or second equation. And on solving the equation, you will get b value. Okay. So if I substitute 1 plus b by b minus 1 here, 1 plus b by b minus 1, I'm substituting in second equation, what I will get? This is x square plus x plus b is equal to 0. Okay, so simplifying this, So clearly b minus 1 whole square is the LCM. I'm writing that directly. 1 plus b whole square plus, after taking b minus 1 whole square as LCM, b minus 1 whole square is the LCM. After taking b minus 1 as LCM, so this will be the situation is equal to 0. Okay, so expand this, what you'll get? 1 plus b square plus 2b. This is in the form of a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square. And this one, don't expand, I'll tell why. Is equal to 0. Here plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled. Then in all terms, we can take b common. So that's why I told don't expand this b minus 1 whole square. So take b common. So 2b square nalli b common andre remaining 2b plus 2b nalli b common andre remaining 2. B into b minus 1 whole square nalli b common andre remaining b minus 1 whole square. So b into 2b plus 2. Now you can expand b square minus 2b plus 1 is equal to 0. So plus 2b minus 2b get cancelled. What we are getting? B into b square 2 plus 1 3 is equal to 0. So thus the answer is b is equal to 0, or b square plus 3 is equal to 0 means b square is equal to, what you will get? Minus 3. So b is equal to plus or minus square root of minus 3. So square root of minus 3 is nothing but iota root 3, I into root 3. But in the option it is given minus iota root 3. Optionally 0 illa, optionally minus iota into root 3 is there. So this same problem you can also solve using condition. So condition for common roots we have already. Condition for the two quadratic equations a1x square plus b1x plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x square plus b2x plus c2 is equal to 0. If these two equations have a common root, we have condition now. And how to remember? I told you already. Write ab minus ab into bc minus bc is equal to ca minus ca whole square. Okay? ab, bc, ca. So here 1, 2, 2, 1. 1, 2, 2, 1. 1, 2, 2, 1. Substitute a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2 values over. Okay? So how we will get this c1, a2 minus c2, a1? So this is like this. C1, a2 minus c2, a1 whole square. Okay? So longest cross multiplication whole square. Next, remind these two factors, what you will get? How we will get? Shortest cross multiplication. Okay? Longest cross multiplication whole square. These are the product of shortest cross multiplications. So this is how we get shortest a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This is also shortest b1 c2 minus b2 c1 is equal to longest a1 c2 minus a2 c1 whole square. Anyway, whole square a1 c2 minus a2 c1 whole square, or c1 a2 minus c2 a1 whole square, both are same only. Next problem, interesting problem. This is also, so the product of the roots of this quadratic equation x square minus 3kx plus 2 into e power ln k minus 1 is equal to 0 is 7. So product of the roots of this quadratic equation is 7. Then we have to find k value so that the roots of this quadratic must be real. We have to find k value so that for that value of k, this quadratic equation must have real roots. Okay. So product of the roots is given 7. So product of the roots formula is what? C by A only now. So what is C here? 2 into e power ln k minus 1 by a, x square coefficient is 1, it is equal to 7.
I think it is a 2 into e power 2 lakh. 2 into e power 2 lakh. 2 into e power 2 lakh. Okay, correction. Okay. So what is a lakh k means? Lakh k means it is the log of k to the base e. And you are familiar with this formula, I think so. E power lakh k is same as what? K. Okay. So then 2 into e power lakh k whole square. Can I write this like this? 2 lakh k as e power 2 lakh k as e power lakh k whole square. A power mn is equal to a power m whole power m. This minus 1 transport that side. What do you get? Plus 1. 7 plus 1 is 8. So e power lakh k is nothing but what? K. So k whole square. 2k square is equal to 8. Then what do you get? K square is equal to 4. So k is equal to plus or minus square root of 4 is plus or minus 2. But lakh k is defined. Log k to the base e is defined only when k is positive. So k must be positive. It is the, they have not given condition, but we have to understand by looking that problem. Okay. So k value positive means k value will be what? 2. Okay. Substitute k value 2 in the above equation. Equation becomes what? X square minus 3kx is 6x. And 2 into e power 2 lakh k minus 1 is nothing but 7 only, na? From this step. Okay. Plus 7 is equal to 0. Check for this k is equal to 2. This equation has real roots or not. Okay. So for that condition is what? Discriminant should be what? Positive or equal to 0. So b square, what you'll get? 36 minus 4 is 4 into 7, 28. It is 8. What you are getting? Discriminant positive. So for k is equal to 2, given equation has real roots. So that means k is equal to 2 is the valid solution. Okay. So k is equal to 2 is the answer. Okay. Next. Next, this is also some interesting problem. So we have to find some of the solutions of this equation. X square minus 5x plus 5 whole power x square plus 4x minus 60 is equal to 1. We have to find the some of the solutions or some of the roots of this equation. See here, it is not a exponent. Here base is a variable. Exponent is also variable. Okay. And but it is given this variable power variable is equal to what? 1. So in which cases we are getting? So that means it is in the form of like a f of x power g of x is equal to 1 or x power y is equal to 1. Okay. So when x power y is equal to 1, either x value 1, y value any real number, first case, that means base is equal to 1, exponent may be any real number, one case, or base is equal to minus 1, exponent must be even number like 2, 4, 6, etc. Okay, so minus 1 whole power even number is also 1 only, na? Okay, 1 power anything is also 1 only, na? So first case, this is 1, this is any real number. So second case, this is minus 1, this is even number. Third case, a power 0, 1 only, na? That means this is any non-zero real number. This should be equal to 0. So a power 0 is 1 only, no? Okay. So these are the three cases. So first case, x square minus 5x plus 5 equal to 1. And this x square plus 4x minus 60 may be any real number. Okay. So this is, if you simplify, what you'll get? X square plus 5x plus 5 minus 1 is 4. Equal to 0. On solving, you will get x value 1 and 4. I am writing directly. So for x value 1 and 4, clearly this is a real number only. Na? So here 1 and 4 are both are valid. Next, second case, x square base function must be equal to minus 1, but exponent must be an even number. It should be an even number. Okay. So, x square minus 5x, 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. Okay. So, for x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0.
So on solving this equation, we'll get x value 2 and x value 3. Correct? Now if you substitute x value 2, 2 square even number, 4 into 2 even number plus even number minus even number is even number. So 2 is valid. Okay? So if you substitute x value 3, 3 square is 9, odd number, 4 into 3, even number. Odd number plus even number, odd number. Odd number minus even number, odd number. That means for x is equal to 3, this x square plus 4x minus 60 exponent is not an even number. So x is equal to 3 is not a valid solution. So first case 1 and 4 both are valid. But second case 2 is valid, 3 is not valid. Next, third case, x square minus 5x plus 5. It should not equal to 0. And exponent must be equal to 0. Base not equal to 0, exponent is equal to 0. So on solving this equation, I am writing directly x value minus 10 and x value 6. Okay. Now if you put x value minus 10 here, what you will get? 100 plus 50 plus 5, 155 not equal to 0. Correct. So x is equal to minus 10 is valid solution. Next, x value 6, if I substitute 36 minus 5, 6 are 30. 6, 6 plus 5, 11. 11 not equal to 0. Correct. That means 10 and minus 10 and 6 are valid. So thus, sum of all solutions is equal to, in first case, what are the solutions? 1 and 4. Second case, 2 only. Third case, minus 10 and 6. So 1 plus 4, 5. 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 6, 13. 13 minus 10, 3. So thus, sum of the solutions of this equation is equal to what? 3. Okay? Next problem. Next problem. So this is also some interesting problem. Okay. So given that a square plus b square plus c square is equal to 1, then what is the range of AB plus BC plus AC? So it is not given anything about ABC. ABC are some real numbers they have given. Okay. So then here one shortcut is, if A square plus B square plus C square is equal to K, then the range of AB plus BC plus CA is closed interval minus K by 2 comma K. That means the minimum value of AB plus BC plus AC is minus K by 2. Maximum value is K. So when its maximum value is K, only when all these three A, B, C must be equal. A is equal to B is equal to C. Then only in that case AB plus BC plus AC is same as K. That is nothing but A square plus B square plus C square. That means these two quantities are equal only when A, B, C are equal. Okay, but here ABC are equal or not equal, they have not given anything. Just given ABC are real numbers. So using this as a shortcut formula, what you will get the answer? Minus K by 2. Here what is K value? 1. So minus 1 by 2 comma 1. So thus the range of AB plus BC plus AC is closed interval minus 1 by 2 comma 1. Under what condition? A square plus B square plus C square is equal to 1. So same problem is given once again. Given a square plus b square plus c square is equal to 1. And also you have given that a is different from b is different from c. A, b, c are not equal. All are not same. All are different. Then a, b plus b, c plus a, c is. Options are given like this. Less than 1, equal to 1, greater than 1. And equal to minus 1 by, equal to minus 1, something is given. Okay, sorry. I think less than, greater than 2 is given. Greater than 2 is given. So here, A, B, C are different. So I told from this shortcut, A, B plus B, C plus A, C maximum value what you will get? K, which is equal to 1. But here ABC are different. Okay, ABC are different. As ABC are different, A square plus B square plus C square value cannot be equal to AB plus BC plus AC. That means AB plus BC plus AC to 1. So answer must be what? It should be less than 1. Because if ABC are equal, then only AB plus BC plus AC, it has a maximum value is K. Here the K is 1. But as A not equal to B not equal to C, then AB plus BC plus AC cannot be equal to 1. It is always less than 1. Okay? This is asked 1 year, this is asked in another year. Next problem. So next problem. So this is also an interesting problem. So find the number of solutions of the equation sine of e power x is equal to pi power x plus pi power minus x. Find the number of solutions of the equation sine of e power x is equal to pi power x plus pi power minus x. So listen here. So here sine function is trigonometry function. So, olagade idu e power x exponential function, 5 power x, 5 power minus 6, both are these two also exponential functions. So, here LHS and RHS, observe, both functions are defined for all x belongs to R. So, domain is clear, all real numbers. Okay. Now, we have to find solution, number of solutions. So, is it possible to solve easily these two equations? No. Correct, Allah? So then how to solve this kind of problem means one method is graphical method. So draw the graph of sine e power x and graph of 5 power x plus 5 power minus x in its domain capital R. So then the number of points of intersection of these two graphs gives the number of solutions. This is a one method. But here it is not required to draw the graph of LHS and as well as RHS. Okay, here we can easily identify what are the ranges of LHS and RHS. So the range of LHS is what? Minus 1 to plus 1 only. Na? Sine theta is always lie between minus 1 to plus 1 only. Na? Okay. And how to find range of 5 power x plus 5 power minus x? 5 power x plus 5 power minus x. Nothing but 1 by 5 power x. So if you observe, it is clearly tending to infinity when x is tending to plus or minus infinity. That means its maximum value is what? Tending to infinite. So that means we need to find its minimum value first. Okay? Minimum value. So to get minimum value of this, so here by looking this function, I want to use this condition, arithmetic mean greater than or equal to geometric mean. Because here we have two terms, one term is 5 power x, other term is 1 by 5 power x. So we have to find minimum value of sum of these two variables, but product of these two variables, 5 power x and 1 by 5 power x is equal to what? 1. So when the sum of the, if you want to find minimum value of sum of two variables, when the product of the variables is a constant, use arithmetic mean greater than or equal to geometric mean, and moreover those quantities must be positive. Okay. Next, if you want to find maximum value of product of two variables or more variables, but their sum is some constant, in that case also you can use arithmetic mean greater than or equal to geometric mean. So arithmetic mean of A and B is A plus B by 2 only. Now, so here A is 5 power x, B is 1 by 5 power x divided by 2. Greater than or equal to geometric mean is what? Root of AB. So 5 power x into 1 by 5 power x. So if these two get cancelled, what will you get? 1. So 2 cross multiply, what will you get? Greater than or equal to 2. So 5 power x plus 1 by 5 power x. 1 by 5 power x is nothing but 5 power minus x. So that means RHS is greater than or equal to 2. Whereas LHS is lie between minus 1 and 1.
So that means, is there any common elements for LHS and RHS? No common elements. That means these two functions are never equal for any real number R. That means this equation has no solution. Given equation has no solution. Okay? Next. Next problem. The set of real numbers satisfying this inequality, x square minus modulus of x plus 2 plus x greater than 0. So your mod function is involved. So here will arise two cases when x plus 2 positive, x plus 2 negative. Okay, suppose x plus 2 is positive or x is greater than minus 2. Then mod x plus 2 is same as x plus 2. So then what you will get? Inequality x square minus of mod x plus 2 is same as x plus 2 plus x greater than 0. So minus into plus x plus x get cancelled. What is remaining? X square minus 2 greater than 0. So x square minus 2 greater than 0 can also be written as x minus root 2 into x plus root 2 greater than 0, because 2 is root 2 whole square, a square minus b square form, a plus b into a minus b. So what you are getting? Roots minus root 2 and plus root 2. So positive, negative, positive. Okay, that means where x minus root 2 into x plus root 2 is positive, either it is less than minus root 2 or greater than plus root 2. But also x must satisfy which condition? Greater than minus 2. Greater than minus 2. Okay, thus what is the common part? X belongs to open interval minus 2 comma minus root 2 union root 2 comma infinity. First case. Okay. Second case, if x plus 2 negative implies that x is less than minus 2. About the mod x plus 2, what you will get? Minus of x plus 2. Minus into minus, plus. So, plus x plus 2 plus x greater than 0. So, x square, x plus x, 2x plus 2 greater than 0. So, x square plus 2x plus 2 greater than 0. But x square plus 2x plus 2, we can also write x plus 1 whole square plus 1 greater than 0. Okay, but x plus 1 whole square plus 1 is greater than 0 for all real numbers. That means this is true for all real numbers, but also x must satisfy which condition? Less than minus 2. So what is the intersection of x belongs to R and x is less than minus 2? So intersection is x is less than minus 2. That means x belongs to, what you will get? Open interval minus infinity comma minus 2. So first case we got this interval, second case we got this interval. Combining these two intervals, you will get the required answer. That means if you treat this as a set A, this is the set B, our required answer is A union B. So one more, this kind of problem only. You try this problem, these two problems, you try these two problems. X square plus 2ax plus 10 minus 3a greater than 0 for all x belongs to R. Then find a value. That means what do you have to take? Discriminant less than 0 only, na? Anyway, x square coefficient is positive. Next two. X square minus 2a into mod x minus a minus 3a square is equal to 0, where a is less than or equal to 0. Okay, here also what you have to take? X greater than a case, x less than a case. Okay, next find the maximum value. Find the maximum value of x square plus 9x plus 17 divided by x square plus 9x plus 7. So just you find range. Just you find range. So suppose you got range is close interval a comma b. Close interval a comma b. That b is the maximum, a is the minimum. Over. Next one. Given that alpha not equal to beta and alpha square is equal to 5 alpha minus 3, beta square is equal to 5 beta minus 3, then we have to find the quadratic equation whose roots are alpha by beta and beta by alpha. We have to find the quadratic equations whose roots are alpha by beta and beta by alpha. See, by looking these two equations, can we conclude like this? Alpha, beta are roots of the quadratic equation x square is equal to 5x minus 3. Then only alpha, beta satisfies, then only we will get these two equations. Okay, this can be written as x square minus 5x plus 3 is equal to 0. So what is the sum of the roots alpha plus beta? Alpha plus beta, sum of the roots, what you will get? 5. Product of the roots, what you will get? 3. But we have to find a new quadratic equation whose roots are alpha by beta and beta by alpha. So for new roots, you find sum and product. For new roots, what is the sum? Alpha by beta plus beta by alpha. Okay, for new quadratic equation, what are the roots? Alpha by beta and beta by alpha. I am finding sum. So, if you take LCM, what will you get? Alpha square plus beta square divided by alpha beta. Then you find alpha square plus beta square in terms of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta. Alpha square plus beta square can be written as alpha plus beta whole square. Alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 into alpha beta. Am I correct? A plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab. From that a square plus b square value is what? A plus b whole square minus 2ab. Like that alpha square plus beta square is what? Alpha plus beta whole square. Nothing but 5 square. Minus 2 alpha beta. Nothing but 2 into 3. Divided by alpha beta as it is. Nothing but 3. So if you simplify that, what you will get? Sum. 25 minus 6. 19. 19 by 3. And what you will get? The product of the new roots. Product of the new roots is what? 1. So, thus the quadratic equation is what? X square minus sum of the roots 19 by 3 into x plus product of the roots 1 is equal to 0. Okay? So, this is the quadratic equation whose roots are alpha by beta and beta by alpha. So, if you take LCM 3, what you will get? Equation 3x square minus 19x plus 3 is equal to 0. That was the required quadratic equation. Okay? Next, last problem, I think so. Yeah, last problem and very, very interesting problem. So this is the previous advanced problem. X power 12 minus x power 9 plus x power 4 minus x plus 1 greater than 0. So we have to find the solution of this inequality. The question is given the largest interval satisfying this inequality. Means we have to find the set of real numbers satisfying this inequality. Okay. So let you take y is equal to x power 12 minus x power 9 plus x power 4 minus x plus 1. Now we have to find the real numbers x for which y is positive. Now here, if you observe, in first two terms, can I take x power 9 common? So what will you get? X cube minus 1 now. And next two terms, if I take common x common, what I will get? X cube minus 1 now. And also plus 1. Now here, if x is a greater than or equal to 1, because here x cube minus 1 is there, that is why when this factor is 0, when x is equal to 1 only now. By looking that, I am telling, okay, when x greater than or equal to 1, okay, so
when x is greater than or equal to 1, x cube minus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. Into is greater than or equal to 0. Here also product is greater than or equal to 0. Plus 1 also there. That means for x greater than or equal to 1, clearly y is positive. Next, you consider x is less than or equal to minus 1. When x is less than or equal to minus 1, this value is negative because x cube is negative only now. So negative minus negative is negative into x power 9 also negative. So negative into negative, positive. Here also same negative into negative, positive. Again, plus 1 is positive. That means for x less than or equal to 1 also y is positive. Now you consider the case 0. Even when x value is 0, what you'll get y value? 1. So again, positive. Now strictly between minus 1 and 1. That is that interval only left on the set of real numbers. So first I will take 0 to 1. When x is lie between 0 to 1, here I'm adjusting y as like this. X power 12 I'm writing as it is. In the rest of these two terms, I'm taking plus x power 4 common. What I will get? 1 minus x power 5 plus 1 minus x. So when x is lie between 0 and 1, when x is lie between 0 and 1, 1 minus x is positive. As x is less than 1, then x power 5 is also less than 1. So again, 1 minus x power 5, positive. Already x power 12, x power 4, positive. So again, y, what happened? Positive. And only one interval left is minus 1 to 0. Even minus 1 to 0 also y is positive. Check. So when x is lie between minus 1 to 0, so as x is negative, 1 minus x is positive. So 1 minus x, positive. As x is negative, x power 5 is negative, but it is lie between minus 1 and 0. Into minus, minus into minus, plus. So 1 plus some number, 1 plus some number, positive number only. Okay, so here as x is negative, x power 5 negative, minus x power 5 positive. So 1 minus x power 5 positive. Already x power 4 positive because power is even now. Here again x power 12, that power also even only now. So that means in this interval also y is positive. So when x greater than or equal to 1 or less than or equal to 1, between 0 to 1 or minus 1 to 0, even at 0, even at minus 1 and 1. So you know, at every real number, x, y is positive. So that means this expression is greater than 0. It is possible for all real values of x. That is, x belongs to R. Or x belongs to open interval minus infinity comma infinity. So with this, I'm going to close quadratic equation. I think you understand all the 9 sessions. Okay. So here in this session, I discussed only what previous year problems. Thank you.